Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate Tip video. Today I will show you how you can activate an entity listener for all of your entities. But before we begin, please take a moment to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get notified about the new Hibernate Tip videos that I publish every week. So here's today's question. We use an entity listener to write an audit log. Is there an easy way to attach the entity listener to all entities? In most cases, you register an entity listener for one entity using the entity listener's annotation on an entity class. That works fine if you use different listeners for each entity class. But it's inconvenient if you want to assign the same listener to all entity classes. In that situation, it's easier to use an XML configuration to register the entity listener to all entities by default. Let's take a look at the code. The easiest way to do that is to create a file called orm.xml and place it in the meta-inf folder of your jar file. All JPA implementations will read and process that file automatically. Here I'm configuring the myEntityListener class as the default entity listener for all entity classes in the persistence unit. The myEntityListener class is very simple. It only has one method that expects an object as a parameter and is annotated with pre-update, pre-persist, and pre-remove. Hibernate calls this method and provides the entity object as a parameter whenever it persists, updates, or removes an entity for which this listener is registered. Let's give it a try and run this simple test case that persists and updates a book entity. As you can see in the log file, Hibernate calls the myEntityListener before the SQL insert and the SQL update statements got executed. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!